The votes, Florida Governor Charlie Crist, who's Republican, is urging the state and national party officials to work something out.
I want the next president to be a Republican, you know, but I feel for my fellow Floridians who happen to be Democrats, their voice should be heard just as much as anybody else's. I'm the governor for all the people of Florida, and I want to make sure that democracy matters, and that whether you're a Republican, a Democrat, or an independent, if you live in Florida, I want to make sure that your vote counts.
Joining me now from Miami to try to sort all this mess out, former U.S. Attorney Kendall Coffey, who's an expert in this area. Coffey was heavily involved in the legal issues in the Florida recount battle 8 years ago. What recount? What are we talking? Kendall,
what recount? And here we go again.
And here we go again. Kendall, thank you so much for joining us. All right. Lawmakers in Florida and Michigan were warned what would happen if they changed the date. What did they think would happen if they changed the date, Kendall?
Well, they probably hoped for the best, but I think the worst they thought was going to happen was that they would lose half their delegates. That's
Kendall,
supposed to be...
I can't believe I'm actually going to have to interrupt you. If you could sit tight, we're going to join a press conference right now about the murder of a co-ed in North Carolina. If you could sit tight for just a moment, we're going to join this press conference in progress.
The police department would like to thank those who have called in to provide information, and we continue to urge anyone with information about this crime to call the Chapel Hill Police Department at area code 919-968-2760 or Crime Stoppers at area code 919-942-751.
To do so would invalidate the votes. Florida Governor Charlie Crist, who's Republican, is urging the state and national party officials to work something out.
I want the next president to be a Republican, you know, but I feel for my fellow Floridians who happen to be Democrats, their voice should be heard just as much as anybody else's. I'm the governor for all the people of Florida, and I want to make sure that democracy matters, and that whether you're a Republican, a Democrat, or an independent, if you live in Florida, I want to make sure that your vote counts.
And joining me now again from Miami to try to sort out this mess. Maybe it doesn't have to be a mess. Former U.S. Attorney Kendall Coffey, who's an expert in this area. Coffey was heavily involved in the legal issues for the Gore campaign in the Florida recount battle 8 years ago. All right, Kendall, let's try this again. Lawmakers in Florida and Michigan were told there would be consequences if they moved up the date. What was their motivation to move up the date, and what did they think would happen?
Well, who the heck knows what politicians are really thinking? Okay. But I think the big miscalculation here is the worst they thought they were facing was to lose half their delegates. That's what the rules normally provide is going to be the punishment if you move to the wrong month. And that is the sanction or the punishment that the Republican Party imposed. Obviously, they were wrong, and the consequences have led us to a potential election disaster.
There are other states that also moved their dates. Were they granted waivers?
Only the states that moved and got waivers were states that already were January states who moved a few days earlier in January. Michigan and Florida were the only February states that tried to jump into January. And so those are the ones that are getting the full punishment from the party.
Okay, thanks for making that clear for us. Okay, we're talking about lots of votes in a really, really close election. Explain to us what the options are, Kendall.
Well, the easiest thing to do, maybe the most difficult from the standpoint of some, is for the Democratic National Party to simply say, we'll seat all the delegates or we'll seat half of them. You could also have a new process in the form of caucuses. You remember those public meetings like they used in Iowa and Nevada? Or there could be a new statewide election. Even some folks are talking about a statewide mail-in election. Problem is, like everything else, Rochelle, the better the option, the more it costs.
Before I get to who's going to pay, what do you think is the most likely outcome?
Well, I think something's got to happen in terms of making those votes count and those votes valid. You can't simply write Florida and Michigan off the map if you're going to have a serious chance of the Democrats winning in November. Right now, the most realistic thing may be a mail-in election. Don't know where the money's going to come from, but consider this. The two Democratic Party candidates together raised $90 million. An election like this might cost $6 or $7 million. Maybe it's the state party and the national party, and who knows who else can put up some money. The Florida and the Michigan voters will have a chance to participate in what may be the most important and certainly the most exciting presidential nomination process in our lifetimes.
Kendall, who has to sign off on this? Does everybody have to say, I'm okay with this?
Well, it depends on the process. But if you use something like a mail-in election that doesn't require the government processes or the local supervisor of elections and things like that, it could just be done by the state party with the concurrence of the national party. But the state party has said that they want both candidates to fully participate in any new process, meaning both candidates have a veto, both candidates, somebody's got to talk to somebody to work this out. But after all, it is the season for backroom deals.
Yes, it is. And are you having any nightmares or visions of hanging chads, Kendall?
At 3 in the morning, it's all coming back. Only last time, it was thousands of voters in hanging chads. This time, unless something is done, there could be millions of voters being left hanging out to dry.
Oh, stay by the phone, Kendall. I'm sure we're going to need you again. Former U.S. Attorney Kendall Coffey. Thanks, Kendall.
Hey, thanks, Rochelle.
All right. The University of North Carolina.